So yeah, this is my my secondary school, where I think I came for about 3 years. I mean, a part of me wishes I did try a bit harder, just because of like mates and that who I know now are always saying, oh, you know, Carl, you're stupid and stuff. You don't know enough. You should know more and all that. But I'm also thinking, well, you know, being intelligent doesn't make you any happier anyway. So yeah, that's just what I sort of want to find out, really.
Hey, could you stand another drink? I'm better when I don't think. Seems to get me through.
I don't think Carl's going to learn anything from this, to be honest. Nothing important stays in there. So I mean, I think he learned everything he was ever going to learn by about 12. But he thought he had two GCSEs, one in art and one in geography. I called the school. He didn't take either of those. He got an E in history. So he didn't remember what stuff he'd take. He doesn't remember turning up to that one.
Do you know, Ricky, this evening we're actually putting Carl into a Mensa test.
OK. First you had to explain to him what a Mensa test was, I assume. I think he'd do all right. I think he's got, quite a good natural intelligence. I think if you take sort of any formal education and knowledge out of the equation, I think he'd surprise you. I think he'd do okay at that, because he's got a good brain. He just he's never used it.
Thanks for taking the test. I hope you'll
do well. Murder. Thought, you know, like they say, go off gut feeling and stuff. But even my gut wasn't kicking in. That wasn't even helping me. But other people in there didn't seem to be struggling. After the first set, there was a woman sat next to me doing a Sudoku. She wanted more. She wasn't happy just relaxing the brain. She just kept going and what have you. I mean, it's multiple choice, so you can take a bit of a lucky dip. Do you know what I mean? Just have a gamble. But I'm not sort of positive about it. I don't think I'll be jumping up and down and what have you. With joy.
I thought I'd go and see like an intelligent person just to see, you know, how they spend their day and see if it's something that, you know, I think, oh yeah, wish I was intelligent.
3 feet tall, with a head like a bowling ball. Can't get up from
I don't do any cooking, by the way. It's like I leave that to the girlfriend most of the time, and I just I wash up.
So do you?
Yeah, I can do that.
That's Jermaine Gray. That's the intelligent person that I'm seeing. She said I could talk to her while she was busy making bread.
Would you say, you know, your intelligence has brought you a lot of happiness? Would you say, you know, if I went out of my way to learn more and read more, would I be happier with it?
I can't make that question make sense, because the happiest people on earth are idiots. Clever is not the same as intelligent, and intelligent is nothing to do with having a storehouse of facts about anything, or even having a good memory.
So what you're saying is then you can be quite intelligent, but you're not always going to be right.
Wouldn't that be dreadful to be always right?
But that's how it comes across with a lot of intelligent people, because they argue a lot and you're like, oh, stop arguing. Just one of you just say you might be right and go home. Do you know what I mean? They're happy to... You see things on, like, Newsnight or whatever, and it's just like, none of them are going to back down. And then they go, that's all we've got time for, see you next week. And you go, well, what's been sorted out? And that's why I don't
like
watching.
Things are not meant to be sorted out.
Well, what's the point in chatting about it?
Can I make this fucking bread?
Yeah, go on, yeah, make a start on it.
You see? That's like what happens on Newsnight. Asked a question, never got an answer.
This should feel like human flesh. Just feel it. It's a bit cool today.
Yeah, that's pretty good, that. That feels nice.
Doesn't it feel nice?
Yeah, that's good. Girlfriend doesn't let me do it anymore. Sort of trying to cook.
That's because you're not giving it enough attention, but I don't...
I sort of give it a go. She walked in one day and they had sausages in the toaster and she went mental at me. Do you know how sausages make a load of mess when you put them in a pan? And I'm quite... It was when I first got a flat and I was really sort of... I wanted everywhere to be clean all the time.
No, I am beginning to think you might be just a tad stupid.
See, sometimes I wonder if I'm meant to be intelligent. Whenever I sort of try to teach myself something, something will happen to stop me learning that thing. Like here, she went off and got me a book, and then look what happens.
Given... Oh, fucking Ada.
Look at this, if we go in a bit, you're stuck in this.
Oh, no, it's all right, I'll manage.
Anyway, I thought now would be a good time to sort of show me Mensa results. I thought they might look better in the dark.
I did a Mensa test. I did one a couple of weeks ago.
And?
You might understand the results. Can I just show you the piece of paper? Because the results are really complicated, and I was like, what does that mean?
But surely you've already realised that Mensa people are the dreariest people on earth.
Yeah.
And the most socially maladroit.
Yeah, they were boring.
They are impossible.
Not if you got a
talk.
And
they generally have nothing but their Mensa qualification.
So what do you think? What would that... Say if you didn't know me, but you saw that piece of paper, and you saw this piece of paper before I came to see you today, what would you be thinking in your head?
Nothing.
You wouldn't judge me by that?
Judge you by the Kettle B scale? No. Whee!
You're going to cut into that?
No, it's got to cool down. But you can take it home if you like.
Can I?
Yep.
What, all of it?
Yep.
Brilliant. I'll have my pie and my mash, gravy.
Oh, you're not a wholemeal bread man. You'll be saying, oh, I'd rather have me white bread. I don't like that bread. It's got roughage in it. It's going to make me have a big shit. It will.
That's good,
big
though,
and
isn't it?
Perfectly formed.
That's good. That's healthy.
It is healthy.
So, not a very good brain, but...
Terrific bowels.
She was nice enough, and I got some sort of free bread out of it, and it was sort of good to know that no matter how sort of different we were in the brain department, we could still sort of both have a laugh about my arse. Anyway, I kind of thought, maybe it's not my fault that I don't know much. I thought it might be my brain's fault. So I went to see this bloke who's a professor who knows all about brains and what have you at this university, where everyone in there sort of looks like a professor.
Making one just for me.
I mean, look, she only makes a tea. Look at her.
Just a little bit of milk, no sugar, please.
That's the fellow I'm seeing there. His name's Heinz. He was going to tell me, you know, how to use my brain better. This is the way. This is the way. He had loads of slides and stuff. He had pictures of, like, brains and Einstein. He had one of a monkey. And he just sort of said the best thing you can do with your brain is just to let it think.
You are, the particular strain of animal, Homo sapiens, you are, is about 80,000 years old, somewhere between 50,000 and 80,000 years old. I'd like to be at that borderline somewhere where it happened, because something happened which suddenly made us so much more competent than the hyenas and lions.
But
and
that's
so
what
on.
I'm saying about, you know, the brain. I don't understand how it jumped so quickly. For me, I mean, you see, do you know you're open to theories and things? Mm. I'm sort of thinking... The brain, is there any chance that could have come from somewhere else? Like an alien. I don't want to say alien because it makes me sound daft.
But I mean, you can, no, not you don't think you're daft. It's simply unlikely. In any case, you haven't solved the problem, or you've pushed it back to another planet, because the phenomenon which puzzles you of saying, how did our brain suddenly become so much more intelligent? Mm. Maybe it was an alien who came and told us about things.
Yeah.
You then ask the question, well, who told the alien?
Who told the alien what?
That who made him clever?
Because they did better, aren't they, on other planets still?
Who says so?
Just because of the spaceships they've got and everything. We haven't got them yet. So if they've got the spaceships, I've got to guess they've got better.
How
better
do you
gear.
Know?
Just when you see them, they look sort of really futuristic.
You've never seen one.
I know,
you?
But I just look at pictures and
I know, but they're pictures are drawn by people like you. I'm not sure this is getting us anywhere. Look, chaps, I think...
See, it's a shame that, because he said in his lecture that, you know, thinking should be fun, and yet look at him, got all annoyed with me. Anyway, I think sometimes having, like, too much information can be a bad thing. The fella I'm on the way to see here, he said his head opened up one day, right? Load of knowledge went in there. Turned his life upside down. It's crawling within you. Alright, welcome back. I'm still sort of on this journey trying to find out if, you know, if I was more intelligent, would it make me more happy? That's what I'm trying to find out. And just on my way to the Isle of Wight here to see a fella who was sort of a bit like me, he got a load of stick for being daft. See the green-eyed monster
on the shore. Carl, how you doing, mate?
That's David Icke. Just in case you don't know, in about 1991 he was on a chat show. He said he was the son of God and that the Queen was a lizard or something. And he got a load of hassle for it. So I just wanted to know how he dealt with sort of being put down.
I never took an exam in my life, Carl. I left school at 15, which was the leaving age at that time. And I look back and I think, what did I miss? I mean, in your life, what of real substance did you... would you have got from school had you concentrated harder and took it more seriously?
Arguing a point. It's something that sometimes I'll be in the pub and I'll say, oh, I've read something about a girl who eats mud. It's something that's gone on somewhere. Now, if I bring that up in a pub and I go, oh, yeah, I've read this thing about a girl eating mud all the time, then someone will go, what are you talking about? And I'll go, yeah, I read it, it's in a magazine. Bit weird, isn't it? And they'll go, it can't happen. Then suddenly, because I don't know all the facts and figures, I'll sort of go, oh yeah, maybe you're right.
Well, I know, but there's two things to that. First of all, you read a woman eats mud. It don't matter if they believe you or not. You know you read it and you know you saw it.
I know, but isn't taking in information all about sharing that information?
I know, well, to an extent, but you can only share with a mind that's open. You came out with a classic then, when you talked about them saying, that can't happen.
Yeah.
That is classic concrete intellect, programmed intellect. That can't happen. This is the only possibility, what I learned at school, what I read in the Daily Telegraph, what they taught me at university. There was the great philosopher in ancient Greece called Socrates, and he was supposed to have said, wisdom is knowing how little we know. Now, that is a fantastic way of looking at life, because your mind is always open to other possibilities. We have a real false version of what intelligence is. You're not a stupid bloke.
No,
you're not.
No.
Okay, you can't regurgitate facts about some bloody war years ago. Okay, you want to know about it? Go on the internet. Buy a book. Hey, it's about that war. Hey, I'll read about
that. It's just little things like before you dropped in a quote of someone's and stuff like that's pretty good. You know what I mean? Just being able to drop, it'd just be nice to have a couple in my head that I can go, oh, you know what so-and-so said back in 46. And that's enough. I think that's all I need, because people would suddenly go, where do you get that from? You know what I mean? Did you do that before to sort of just show off a bit, or did you do that?
No, I'm trying to use quotes to make my point. But the thing is that what you're saying there is, if I had a few quotes, then they'd see me differently. Why are you bothered about how they see you? You are what you are. Me? I don't care if I'm seen as intelligent, stupid, crazy, off the wall, having a midlife crisis, any of it. I'm just interested in what is. And if what is not what the system's version is, then fuck 'em. And the key, Carl, is not to buy it. Because it doesn't matter if people think you're stupid. I don't think you're stupid.
No, well, it
doesn't matter if they do.
Grinds you down a bit.
Well, it does, mate. If you allow it to grind you down. I mean, I'm the living proof, say the bloody least, that you can take enormous amounts of ridicule over a long period of time, and still keep going on the journey that you think is right. And following the path that you think is right.
You've got to sort of trust the experts, haven't you? I had, like, a fella around when I had a problem with the fridge, and he was, like, a professional fridge fixer. And yet he said,
when did you last back it out? I should be able to go, well, he knows what he's talking about. He's a fridge fixer. But I've never heard anyone talk about backing out a fridge. So it's, who do you listen to?
You have to, in the end, you know, the whole thing is, we have a filter which we need to trust, and it goes under the name of intuition. Because there are great fridge fixers who have qualification, I'm a qualified fridge fixer.
Yeah.
And there are qualified fridge fixers who are shit.
I think he was that one.
So we have to make that decision on the basis of what we think is right. We just have to follow our heart and our intuition and our feelings. And, you know, you're not a stupid man. And if people tell you that you're stupid, it's because they are intellectual snobs who are themselves stupid because they have accepted a version of programmed intelligence and they're trying to impose it on you. Fuck them.
Right. Fair enough. I like David, he was all right. And what you don't know is I sort of have problems with kidney stones and stuff. And I was in a bit of pain that day, and after the chat, he made us a brew, gave us some herbal tablets. Never had the pain since, so it's good of him, that. I liked him.
This is where I did English, just in this classroom here, which is a subject I didn't do that well in. Mainly down to the fact that I don't think the teacher was that good. Do you know, like, normally kids sort of read a classic novel to sort of study and what have you. Well, we were doing that, but it wasn't Shakespeare or anything like that. It was Dr. No, Ian Fleming. So it sort of gives you an idea of, you know, what the school was like back then. I'm sure it's better now, but because, I mean, the amount of books they've got on the shelf there is more than I saw in the 3 years, I think.
You see, that's another thing. I don't read that many books yet, you know. Intelligent people love them, don't they? Like this fella who I went to see, he writes for a living, and he's really intelligent, yet, I don't know, every time I see him, I just think, oh, look at him, he looks miserable. His name's Will.
Hello.
Hello, Will. How's it going?
You must be Carl.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
Come in.
You well on that?
I'm extremely well. Mens sano, sano corpore, Carl.
I don't know what that means.
Healthy mind and a healthy body.
Is that still the main thing to have?
That and a Volvo. You sit on that uncomfortable wire chair, and I'll sit here on this much nicer chair.
That's fine, yeah.
Can you just look into my eyes for a minute, very deeply into my eyes, because I'm going to just do a little test on you, okay? Now just don't flinch. Right, can you feel that?
Yeah.
Okay, because with this, I can measure the size of your corpus callosum. Yeah, which is what joins the right and left hemispheres of your brain. And I can tell whether there's a restriction in the passage of information.
I think the right hand's good. I've looked into that. And they said if your right hand part of the brain is bigger, that's your creative bit.
Yeah.
And I looked in the mirror, and because I've got a bald head, you can actually see, if you look at that there, look at that profile, right? Remember that bit?
Mm.
Look at that side.
Oh, yes, it's considerably enlarged.
So that's what I mean. So I think in regards to that, I've got the good bit of the brain.
Can you feel that?
It's pretty heavy, that.
Is it restricting your thoughts?
I wasn't thinking about anything.
Yeah, it's restricting your thoughts a bit. I mean, for a start, we need to test your cognitive ability a bit more, so I'd like you to do something for me while I talk to you.
Yeah.
So I'd like you, could you stand up and get a pipe from the rack? Pick one you like.
I like that one.
You like that one? It's interesting you would choose that pipe.
Why?
Because that pipe is exactly modelled on one smoked by Tony Benn. I should imagine Tony Benn's a figure that you find quite appealing.
The only thing I know about him was a bit of artwork that he liked.
I see. You don't know anything about Tony Benn?
No, I just saw this thing. It was in the back of a Sunday supplement.
Okay.
Where he was sort of talking about his favourite bit.
So you don't know anything about his politics? Or
not really.
That he was once Viscount Stansgate? You don't know nothing about that? You are a very ignorant chap, aren't you?
See, look at him, he hates me. This is what I worry about. If I sort of turned intelligent, is this what I'd have to be like? Anyway, he got me to clean his pipes for him whilst we had a chat.
This is an intelligent thing to do, isn't it?
Well, I mean, pipes are associated with thought, aren't they? You automatically think of Sherlock Holmes, or perhaps you don't.
No, I just think of old man.
Old man.
So do you... Are you happy that you're intelligent?
Well, I don't know. It's not really for me to judge. You see, intelligence is instrumental. You know, these chaps who are telling you when you talk about things that you've read that you're daft, are they intelligent?
Well, it's just that there's more of them, so you go with the masses, don't you?
I see.
All I came here for was to, just to find out if it's worth me reading a few more books or watching the news more or...
Yeah, but what sort of books do you want to read? I mean, do you want to read the Tractatus Logico-Philosophicus? Do you want to read...
Maybe not to start with. The last book that I read, it was about the governor. And it's this sort of London gangster. I just was struggling with it. It was jumping about a bit, the story. You know, it was like one minute he was 12 and then he was like, you know, in prison and stuff.
And you wanted a straight narrative.
Well, but the thing is, I realised it was because all the pages were mixed up.
Oh, I see.
So it was. I got halfway through it and was struggling with it, saying, I can't follow this. And then I turned the page and it was like chapter one. It was like, oh, the one time I tried to, you know, read a book and it all went wrong.
That was the one time you tried to read, recently you tried to
recently,
read a book.
Recently, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, do you
feel he's in a totally different league to me, that's the problem with him. There's no way that he'd be happy sat in a pub with me talking about, you know, a woman who eats mud. It's just not going to happen.
John Stuart Mill, the philosopher, said, better to be Socrates, i.e. a great philosopher, and dissatisfied than a pig satisfied. I mean, when you talk about being happier, would you like to be just a happier pig?
Yeah.
You would?
Yeah, because that's all...
Well, fuck off then. Stop wasting my time.
No, but surely that's...
No. I'm a busy man. That is not what life is about at all. You're the proverbial bird in the hand, man. You know, you're worried about grabbing for the bush for fear that you're going to lose the bird you've already got in your hand.
Yeah,
and that is your anxiety. And what I'm saying to you is nothing ventured, nothing gained. I feel, and you arouse these conflicting emotions in me. On the one hand, I really do just want to kick you down the road. And on the other hand, I want to take all your clothes off and soap you gently with palm olive and clean you tenderly and put you to bed.
Both of them sound bad to me.
Yeah.
So, not, do you know what I mean? That isn't even a
bird. Well, that doesn't make me feel very good, you rejecting me in that way.
It's just, I'm not that happy with my body. Anyway, nice to meet you, though.
Well, sort of nice to meet you. Sort of nice.
That was all a bit weird, that. I don't think I'd want to be as intelligent as him. I just want to be able to get by and maybe, you know, say the odd thing now and again that people go, yeah, he knows what he's talking about. I got that book that you mentioned, and I couldn't understand it. I thought the pages were in the wrong order again. It was easier to read The Governor. And I'll be honest with you, I haven't really learnt anything from this. Just maybe some of us are not meant to be really intelligent. You've just got to sort of make the most out of what you've got and, you know, just get on with it, really. And I'm not sure if I want to be more intelligent anyway, because at the end of the day, if I was, you know, would I be me anymore?